Good morning everyone. Welcome back to your English class. Today I am going to teach you chapter number 5, the 100 dresses. So this is part 1 of 100 dresses. This chapter is written by Elbasor Easter. So here in this introduction of this chapter, the 100 dresses is a story about a girl who is teased by her classmates because she is different. Wanda Petronsky, a girl who comes from the poor part of town and is the only student in her class with a funny Polish name. So here, first of all, there are three characters in this story. One was Wanda, who was different, who was a poor girl. Another was Maddie, and the third is Peggy. Maddie and Peggy were both true friends, were good friends. And Wanda was different from others. So in this chapter, Wanda Petronsky, a girl who comes from the poor part of the town, is the only student in her class with a funny Polish name. Polish means who are from Poland. She is always quiet and she always wears the same faded blue dress to school every day. Although she claims she has 100 dresses at home, all lined up in her closet. And the story is told from the perspective of one of Wanda's classmates, Maddie, who is the best friend of the main player, Peggy, in the daily taunting and teasing. Maddie begins to wonder about the girl she and her friend used to constantly tease and realizes that she knows very little about her. She begins to wonder why they started teasing her and in the first place and is overcome with the guilt for making fun of her simplicity because she is poor and has a funny name and is different from them. Maddie knows that she should have stood up to her friends and defended Wanda. And she feels guilty for not speaking up, for standing by and allowing her friend to tease Wanda. Maddie and her friends later discover that Wanda is a very talented artist and that her drawing of 100 beautiful dresses has won the school's art contest. And the girls realize that they misjudged Wanda and feel incredibly guilty for never believing her stories of her 100 dresses, because she had actually 100 dresses, designs of 100 dresses. So that's why she always used to talk about those dresses. So summary of this chapter is, it was your introduction, students. Now summary of the chapter is, now I'll tell you the summary in points, students. So point number one was Wanda Petronsky seat. Here I'm going to tell you one by one. According to the chapter, I have made points for you. So point number one in the starting was Wanda's Petronsky's seat. So Wanda's seat was, Wanda Petronsky was a young Polish girl whose family had immigrated to America. Immigrated means goes from one place to another place. There is one of the towns she studied in a school with other American students. And Wanda belonged to a poor family and could not afford to wear new dresses. and therefore she would come to school in a faded blue dress every day. Her dress was clean but not properly ironed. Wanda had a fixed seat in her class and she used to sit in the corner of room number 13 in the last row. And this was a corner where the rough boys sat and made a lot of noise. Often there occurred a lot of noise of the feet. When some fun occurred, Wanda was not like them. On the contrary, she was very quiet and timid. She did not speak too much. But as she came on the foot from the Boggins height, it was area, Boggins height area, Wanda was not like them. On the contrary, she was very quiet and timid and brought a lot of dirt with her shoes because she was coming from Boggins Heights area, and that area was not so posh area, just like their others area who were so rich. She preferred to sit away from the students who allied class, students of allied class who made fun of her poverty, because she was a poor girl, so all of them used to make fun of her. So point number two was, Peggy makes fun of Wanda. Peggy was a rich girl and she always make fun of her. Wanda was a kind of an introvert girl and kept quiet most of the time in her class. In fact, nobody had ever heard her laugh, and students paid attention to her only outside the school hours. While going back home, they waited for her in order to make fun of her. Two of her classmates, Peggy and Maddie, often did so. Peggy was pretty, but with curly hairs, and was most popular girl in the school. As she belonged to a rich family, she had several pretty clothes. Maddie, on the other hand, came of a moderate family but was Peggy's closest friend. So then point number three, students, 100 dresses and 60 pairs of shoes. So I have told you point number one, Wanda's seat. Point number two, Peggy makes fun of Wanda. Now point number three is 100 dresses and 60 pairs of shoes. So Wanda Petrowski would become a victim of criticism and fun because of her weird name and her faded dress. Peggy and Maddie were not bad girls, but they used to have some fun with Wanda as they found her name funny. Peggy made fun of Wanda and asked her how many dresses she had in her closet. Closet means in her wardrobe, in her almirah. Every time Wanda would reply that she had 100 dresses of different colors and designs. And Peggy would also ask her if the dresses were made of silk. Wanda would reply that she had dresses of silk as well as of velvet. On being asked, Wanda would also tell them that she had 60 pairs of shoes also. The girls would suppress their laugh when talking to her. But as soon as Wanda's back was turned, they would burst into peals of laughter. Means they all were just laughing on her. They used to laugh on her. They used to make fun of her. So it was point number three. Now point number four, Peggy and Maddie seems to be mischievous. but she was not. Peggy was seems to mischievous, but she was not arrogant. Rather, she saved younger girl from the bullies. But she and other girls could not understand why Wanda behaved strangely and gave false statements about her dresses and shoes, because they all thought that she was so poor. Then how was it possible that she would have 100 dresses and those shoes also? However, the girls only made fun of Wanda. They never made her cry. Maddie too was a poor girl. So here Maddie was also a poor girl, but she was best friend of Peggy and used to wear the clothes given by the others. So she was little sympathetic towards Wanda, but never objected to Peggy's remarks, as both were fast friends. So Peggy and Maddie were fast friends, and Peggy has sympathy for Peggy had sympathy for Wanda also, but she never protested against Peggy, because Peggy was her best friend and she never wanted to go against Peggy. Whenever Peggy mocked at Wanda, Maddie felt bad. Even she wished that Peggy should stop teasing Wanda, but Maddie even decided to write a note for Peggy asking her to stop making fun of Wanda, but she could not muster up the courage to do so. And it happens, students, it happens when we have some best friends. Sometimes they do wrongs, sometimes they do something bad, but because they are our good friends, we never say anything to them, because we don't want to we don't want to go against of our friends, that's why. But same was with Maddie also. She did not want to hurt her friends, that's why she didn't say anything to her. Okay, it was next point, students, the drawing and color contest. Now in their school there was a drawing and color contest, and Wanda was absent from the school on Monday, but nobody missed her because she was not so important for anyone. She remained absent next day also, but when she missed the school for the third consecutive day, on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie noted her absence. They wondered why she had not come to school, and Maddie remembered Wanda talking about one of her dresses also, which was pale blue with colored trimmings. Meanwhile, a drawing and color contest approached nearer, and Maddie began thinking about it. The girls were to design dresses and the boys were to design motorboats. In Maddie's opinion, Peggy would win the contest as she was very good at making designs. But the result was, another point, the result. It was the day when Miss Mazin would announce the result of the drawing contest. Maggie and Peggy hurried to their school as it was drizzling. Nobody waited for Wanda, and the girls reached their school. Only to the surprised, hundreds of designs of dresses were displayed in the room. And Miss Mazin announced that Jack Bengals had won for the boys. So who was the winner in boys? Jack Bengals. And in girls, who was the winner? It was our Wanda. She also said that all 100 designs of dresses had been made by one girl, and who had won the medal, and she was no other but Wanda Petronsky. So it was a surprise for all of them, Wanda's absence. But Wanda was not there. Everyone was astonished, surprised to know that Wanda could draw, but she was absent. And became okay. She was absent on that day too. Everyone applauded as the sketches made by her were all beautiful and different. Peggy and Maddie identified the blue and the green dress once mentioned by Wanda, and they were shocked to know her great quality of drawing and appreciated her drawings wholeheartedly. So now they were feeling bad. They thought that Wanda was actually a talented girl, and they all were making fun of her, and she was not lying. She had actually those dresses which were in her designs. So theme of this chapter is, one of the theme of the story is bullying, because even though Peggy and Maddie do not think of their teasing as bullying and do not mean to make Wanda unhappy, and it is bullying nonetheless. So Maddie begins to recognize it as such, but does not want to say anything in case the teasing transferred to her instead of Wanda. And another theme is racial discrimination. So theme of this chapter is, there are two themes of this chapter. Number one is bullying and number two is racial discrimination. So characters, I have told you there are three characters: Wanda, Maddie and Peggy. So it was your chapter, students. I hope now you know about your this chapter, and I hope you liked it. Today your work is to understand the chapter. You have to read this chapter, and that's it for today. I hope you liked it. Bye for now. Have a nice day.